On the other hand, we know that constant updating of your skills, of your knowledge, and of what you learn is important. So yeah, there's kind of a discrepancy there, I think. And so more and more of this need to update your skills and need to update of learning is pushed onto the individual, pushed into the workplace. Yeah, you can do this while you're actually working.
An effective DNA is particularly vital in today's changing workplace as new technologies and flexible working practices are becoming common, leading to changes in the skills and abilities needed. And with the need for cost-effective solutions, organizations need to ensure that the resources that they invest in training are targeted at areas where training and development is really needed.
Analysis, design, development, implementation, and evaluation. The model's original authors are unknown, but there are multiple variations and versions of the model today.
So what is TNA and why is it important? Training needs analysis is the first step in the training cycle, and it involves a procedure to determine whether training will indeed address what is needed for your organization, for your department, and for each individual.
During the analysis phase, the designer identifies many things, including the learning problem, goals and objectives, the needs of the learner, the existing knowledge of the learner, the environment in which learning will take place, and constraints.
SMEs, they usually hold a very specialized type of knowledge, and that's what makes them important and strong. They don't produce mass market kind of things. They are very specialized usually, and they have a strength in very particular fields, and so there's a very high need for them. They cannot send their staff to like these general trainings. They have very, very special kinds of needs and expertise.
During the design phase, the designer goes through the process of specifying learning objectives, storyboards, prototypes, the user interface, and the content.
It's about taking the technology into the workplace and finding the best ways of using it to support learning, understanding how people currently work and how they learn at work, not going off to courses, not attending training sessions, but actually how you learn just by doing your job.
The content and the learning materials are produced, all based on the design phase. The implementation phase, the content from phase 3 is put into production. The training for the learners and for the instructor or teacher are put into place and used. During the final and fifth phase, the evaluation phase, the designer assesses criteria used and gathers learner feedback.